Hello, Home Slices. This is Kiara with Home Slice Adulting, and I'm coming to you with my first upload in like 3 or 4 months. First and foremost, I want to thank you for clicking on this video. And for those of you who subscribed while I was away, not uploading, I want to say thank you because you saw something in my content and said I wanted to see more. So thank you for hopping aboard, even in my absence. And for those of you who were subscribers prior to my absence, thank you so much for sticking around. It really does mean a lot to me. But enough of that. You all are here because I am doing a movie review for The Green Book. Now, I went to go see The Green Book yesterday, so it is quite fresh on my mind. And the first thing I want to say about this movie review is that I never do spoilers. I do not want to spoil it for you. I'm not going to reveal any major plot twist or anything along those lines. So don't worry about that. Now let's get into this review. Now, for the most part, more recently, I've kind of been, you know, kind of riding that wave of like, I'm tired of the racial movies, but something about the Green Book's previews kind of changed my mind about that, and I wanted to see this. So I dragged my boyfriend along with me, and he didn't even remember seeing any previews for it, but the movie was so enjoyable. He really liked it, even more so than Spider-Man Into the Spideyverse, and I'm gonna, or Spider-Verse, I'm gonna talk about that in a different video. The fact that I was watching a movie that was racially motivated, that was actually about friendship between two people of different races, kind of felt like it was in a different vein than other movies that are about slavery and, you know, police brutality. I enjoyed The Green Book for a lot of reasons. I felt like the fact that it was based on a true story, I enjoyed that. I enjoyed the fact that the two actors who played in this movie did a very good job. The two main characters are, and I am pretty sure I'm not gonna be able to pronounce this man's name correctly, Mahershala Ali and Viggo Mortensen. Okay. Well, let's just say that. But for those of you who don't really know what The Green Book is about, here is kind of like a teaser summary from like Wikipedia or IMDb. Dr. Don Shirley is a world-class African-American pianist who's about to embark on a concert tour in the Deep South in 1962. In need of a driver and protection, Shirley recruits Tony Lip, a tough-talking bouncer from an Italian-American neighborhood in the Bronx. Despite their differences, the two men soon develop an unexpected bond while confronting racism and danger in an era of segregation. So this movie came out over a month ago, so I guess that's why it was kind of in a select number of theaters this time around, because it's been out for a little while. And it did $27.7 million in the box office. And here are just a few numbers regarding the ratings from other people. So Rotten Tomatoes, the critics, gave The Green Book a 82% approval rating. Rotten Tomatoes critics are very hard to please, so I think an 82, it's a B, it's pretty good. But the audience, you know, non-critics who also rated the movie, gave it a 95%, and I think that's more so along the lines where I am leaning. So in this movie, the things that I loved about it is that they took us along on a journey with them, and we they spent 2 months together on this tour, and the tour started out in some of the northern states, and things, you know, progressively got more challenging as they moved into the Deep South. And Tony Lip, whose real name is Tony Vallelonga, is a real tough guy who's a bouncer at the Copacabana, and the Copacabana shuts down for 2 months for repairs, and he needs to find a job to support his family, and he ends up working for Dr. Don Shirley. He didn't really understand how a musician could be called doctor, or, you know, the fact that he was a black man, and he had some of his own internal prejudices, which, you know, makes sense in the 1960s. But because he was making good money doing a job that was fairly simple, where all of his expenses were paid and he was able to, you know, take care of his family while he was out of work, he did it. And their journey along the way is very very interesting, and in a lot of ways it's like the shoe is on the other foot. as a doctor, as a very educated man, as a well-traveled musician, Don Shirley, who is the person that Mahershala Ali plays. I'm sorry if I'm mispronouncing his name. But he is very educated, he is very well spoken, and interestingly enough, the white guy, the driver, is an Italian American who is very rough around the edges, is very eager to fight, has a very hot temper, and has a thick, you know, Bronx accent and does not speak proper English. So it's weird because this movie put the shoe on the other foot in almost every way possible. You have a white man who is working for a black man, so that's new. We have an educated black man who is trying to give an uneducated white person some couth. That shoe is on the other foot. There's a lot of things that happen in this movie that challenge your thoughts of the way things are or the way things are supposed to be, and I love that about this movie. And for me, I feel as if both the actors did a really good job, and I'm trying to tell you guys how much I really enjoyed this movie without giving too much away. But like I said, the movie takes you along a journey of these two people being totally different from what you expect them to be. There are issues that about identity that come up. There are issues about, of course, racism and segregation that come about, education levels, you know. There is some violence in the movie, of course. They're, you know, in the Deep South in 1962. There's some really interesting things that happen in this movie. And I felt as if I was on the journey with them, and we see these two people from these two different worlds come together and find some type of friendship with each other. And so the last thing I'm gonna talk about that was a theme throughout the movie was about identity. And so, as an educated black man in the 1960s, and as someone who is well traveled and all those types of things, Dr. Don Shirley had a problem finding out who he was. He would perform for white people, but he would not be able to use the bathrooms in the establishment, or he would have to walk through the kitchen to get to the venues, those type of things. So he didn't quite fit in with white people. Black people felt that he was too well-dressed, too educated, didn't want to participate in black things that regular black people participated in at that time. And so he felt like he wasn't black enough. And there's another aspect of his identity that I'm not gonna get into, but you all will see in the movie. And so he just has this battle within him, and we see how these people go from just being a white man and a black man to see them actually becoming friends. And it's such a great story. So you all should definitely go out and see it. A part of me feels like I have not explained enough, like I have not convinced you enough to go see this movie, but you definitely should go see it. It's a great movie, 95% from non-critics, and I'm leaning along those lines, 95%. I'm 95% positive you should go see this movie. It's great. So thank you guys for watching. I'm going to be doing another review for the Spider-Man movie, Into the Spider-Verse, and that should be posted shortly. So I'm going to put a link in the description box, and I'm also going to put a link in the top right corner of this video for you to check that out as well. I'm going to be doing my best to try and make this a more regular thing, and thank you guys so much for watching. Peace out, home slices.